What do you think that all, that Michael Jordan and his great observation, you've always had sort of ridiculous expectations.
Yeah, I never brought that upon myself. I always just tried to be as simple as possible to support the rest of my ability as possible. I've never liked it. I never brought it upon myself. I just try to be like everybody else. I try to be in the right way, work to my best ability, and try to be as respectful as possible to everybody.
Your game lot mix as well with like a street ball life?
Yeah, actually I think it makes it easier to play with the guys that are sitting here because it makes my job easier. You just have to get them the ball at the right time and they'll know what to do with it already. So I also like to play up and down and we can just work out about that, how they like to get the ball out or hopefully push like that's out too. So I think it should be a lot of fun.
What was the style of play on the team in Israel much different from what you see in Kiel or Europe or anything
else? I think so. It's a lot different. I think in Israel specifically, it's very, very, it's very, very structured. And you don't have really much freedom at all to do what you want to do, what you create. You have to run some plays all the way to the end, even if there's a better option sometimes. So it's different. I have to play both styles. Like I said, I'm still going to do as best as you can ever still do. I can play both styles, but naturally I grew up playing American soccer.
Right. So that had to be a huge adjustment in itself. Once you went to Israel, they start playing.
And most American players feel that way in their first conference in Israel. It's a good adjustment.
What are you at physically, Samir? You were balanced with injuries?
Yeah, I feel great. I think I feel good. I'm very excited to start balance.
I just wanted to mention when you were asking the question of Alabama's response about his attitudes and so forth. But one thing when I met Charlie Green to Kiwanis director of officials, I said, look, I only have one rule, and that's all I want. The rest is up to you, and that's what I told Charlie was the no knucklehead rule. And from a league standpoint all the way down, they're fighting any of that kind of nonsense. It's really basically a zero tolerance policy. If we're preaching and we're saying this is about kids and family, then the last thing I want is, and I'm not saying that it won't happen, it's just if it does happen, then punishment would be swift and severe as that. So, and then I think the guys, all the teams understand this.
So, did you go to Israel straight after college?
Yes.
How many teams did you
play for? Three or four, depending, because they either go some teams to buy you and they own you, but they own you out, so they say. So, three and a half.
Yeah, we'll have all the players available. Tom and Jeanette as well, and Lawrence for one-on-one interviews. Thank you everyone for coming today.
Great, thank you guys so much.